be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, would I have told you? I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you shall be also. At this time we are gathered to give thanks and praise for the life of Winston. And we ask God's blessing upon everything that should be said and done. Shall we pray? Our blessed God and Father, we give thanks this evening for the gift of thy well-beloved Son, our blessed Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. We thank him for dying on Calvary's cross for our sins, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. We ask thy blessings and thy guidance upon this service, that thou will bless everything that should be said and done, and grant that if there be any in the hearing of our voice who do not know thee as their personal and indwelling Savior, that they will seek to do so. So we give thanks, lead on by the power of the Holy Spirit, who is thus seated away in thy presence. These mercies we ask with thanksgiving in the name of thy Son, our blessed Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Would you kindly silence your cell phones? We are going to have the first hymn, Spirit Lead Me. Start it first.
All right, we're going to sing our first hymn, our opening song, entitled Spirit Lead Me, and it is on page 2 of your leaflet. And we're going to sing accompanied with the music.
The great unknown. Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you will call me.
Take me deeper than my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior.
Kindly be seated. At this time, we'll have the first scripture reading. It's Psalm 46, and it should have been done by Cassara Tate, but Victor Grant is sitting in for her. But Victor Grant, please come and read it. 46 Psalm.
Let me say a blessed good evening to all. As Pastor Dong said, the Bible reading will be taken from Psalm 46, reading through verses 1 to 11. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof. There is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles and the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. The heathen raged, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come, behold the works of the Lord. What desolations he hath made in the earth. He maketh wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Here endeth the first Bible reading. Amen.
Thank you very much, Mr. Grant, for that reading. At this time, we'll have the eulogy, and it'll be done by Ronald Holden.
Pleasant good evening to one and all. A little appreciation about my brother Winston Hinkson. Winston was born on the 22nd of August 1955 and was the son of the late Trent Hinkson and Daphne Callender Hinkson. Winston had four brothers, namely Erskine, Patrick, Charles, and the late David, and three sisters, namely Betty, Glory, and Gloria, and Annie. He attended the St. Elizabeth Primary School. As a boy, Winston was a social young man. Growing up in Hillswick, he would engage in various sports with the Hillswick youngsters, such as cricket, football, and dominoes. Out of all the sports he played, he mastered the game of dominoes. And I must say, beating him in this game was a hard task. As every young boy does, Winston had a vivid imagination. One memory I have of him as a boy, we all of the Hillswick boys used to pretend we were drivers, and we used to drive around the district with those barrels, the top of the barrels, and pretend we were bus drivers. And Winston enjoyed this to the maximum. So much so that he even had a special license plate on his, which was 043. And 043 was a car that belonged to Jones River Plantation in those days. And anybody that lived around here knew that 43 was real fast. And he would pretend to drive all around the neighborhood. And best believe that he was the fastest driver out of all of us. During the summer vacation, the boys would spend long days at the beach as well as in the gully, where we all used to participate in catching crayfish. On leaving school, Winston went on to become a mason and practiced his trade all over the island. Winston continued this social trade from his childhood. In adulthood, where he was seen linemen talking and socializing with his peers at the various corner shops in the area. Winston was a very special and very easygoing and friendly individual. And he was a very smart dresser. And you don't want to get in any argument or getting any thing with Winston, because he was very, 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 he would get very hostile if anyone really troubled him. Apart from that, he was a cool, easygoing person. And at this time, I would like to thank take this opportunity to express my sincere condolences to the family of the late Winston Hickson. During this time of bereavement, and may he continue to rest in eternal peace. I thank you very much.
Amen. Thank you very much, Mr. Holder, for that eulogy. It must be the real thing because y'all was neighbors together. Thank you for it. Next Bible reading will be John, 1 John 4, 7 to 11, Javonte Callender. Please come forward.
Good evening, everybody. The reading is taken from 1 John 4, verses 7 to 11. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. In this was manifested the love of God toward us, because that God sent his only begotten Son into the world, that we might live through him. Herein is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we ought also to love one another. There ends the Bible reading. Amen.
Thank you very much, Bonte Callender. At this time, we have a hymn, the second hymn, Nobody Greater Than You. Would you kindly stand at the card?
Radio, Bluetooth.
Sometimes technology can be unpredictable.
Is Bluetooth connected.
But yes, we're gonna go on. So as soon as the music starts, we're gonna sing Nobody Greater Than You. And of course this song talks about the greatness of God that no one can compare to the God that we serve. Thank you.
searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater, nobody greater, no, nobody greater than you. Searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater, nobody greater, nobody greater than you. Nobody can heal like you can. Oh, most holy one, you are the greatest. Awesome in all your ways, and mighty is your hand. You are he who carried our redemption plan. You are he who carried our redemption plan.
I'm from the old school, so I'm a bit lost. Before our brother Junior comes to speak, I would just like to say a few words, especially on behalf of Barbara. She regrets very much that she could not join us here. And because of that, I make sure that it is recorded so that she can follow the service. I'm sure there are many faces that would be here that she would see, and you all would want to wish her your sympathy. Maybe at the graveside, we can do some waving of hands to her. I know Winston for a very long time. My family and his family was very intimate friends, and we visit the home on very regular occasions. Winston grew up in a very godly home, because at one point, I believe there were 7 or 8 of his family was here in fellowship at one time. And as I spoke to Barbara, she said that it is only, but not him, no, he's gone. She's the only one left. We told them she's the only one left that is remaining from the Gall and the Hinkson and the Sargent family. all the other relatives are gone. And Barbara and him was very close, because there was no one else to keep in touch with but him. So on behalf of my family and the friends that are here, we would extend deepest sympathy and condolences to her. Her husband, he would love to be here. We are close because me and him share birth dates together. So we are glad for that knitted family. So we ask God's blessing upon the remainder of the service as we continue, as our brother will speak. God bless everyone for his name's sake. Amen. At this time, Samuel Dong Jr. will bring us the address.
Yes, good evening, everyone. Yes. Good evening, everyone. Amen. Yes, it's such a pleasure to see so many people here this evening coming to commemorate and celebrate the life of Winston Archibald Hinkson. And of course, we've come to commemorate and celebrate his life. We've come to remember him. But this evening, for my message, I want to focus on God's greatest gift to mankind. And this is a gift that every single human being has access to. This is a gift that every single human being can receive without any costs attached, without any strings attached. And this is a gift that every human being can access, as I said, and it's a gift that God desperately wants to give us. I know that there are many things in this world that we will want. How many of you will want a new house? How many of you will want a mansion? Raise your hands, honestly. Okay, yeah, we have two honest people over here. How many of you would like how many of you would like someone to just give you a good $10,000 right now, free of cost? All right, yes, so we have five honest people in the crowds. Okay, that's good, that's good. How many of you would like someone to give you a brand new car? A BMW, Mercedes-Benz, something like that. Yes, amen, amen, sister. I'm going to put my hands up as well. Yeah, I'm going to put my hand up as well. Yes, and we know that that these things, you know, they're good. There's nothing bad with having a good house. There's nothing bad with having money. There's nothing bad with having the good things in this life. But there's something that is more important than all the material possessions in this world. And that thing is salvation.
The Bible tells us that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whomsoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And Jesus said also that Satan comes not but to kill, steal, and destroy, but I have come to give life, and life more abundantly. You see, we as human beings are flawed. We are deeply flawed beings. And we all know that. We can see from the world around us how corrupt the world is. We can see how much evil is in this world. We can see how people treat each other, how people treat each other with disdain, with disrespect, how people are self-centered and selfish and only care about themselves. And that, all of that behavior is a result of sin. Sin that we inherited from our forefather, Adam, who rebelled against God in the Garden of Eden, and he chose to obey the serpent instead of God. And the Bible tells us in Romans that if we yield ourselves to whomsoever we yield ourselves to obey, the same becomes our master. So if we yield and to Satan, if we yield to the voices of the enemy, then Satan is our master. But if we yield to the Spirit of God, if we look to obey God's Spirit, then we become children of God. And this evening, the Lord is telling all of you that if thou shalt confess thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. All that scripture In Romans 10, verse 9 to 10, all that is telling us is that if we are willing to turn away from our sins, if we are willing to confess Jesus as our Lord and Savior, and ask Him to come into our heart, ask Him to come into our life and be our Lord and Savior, then we are saved and we are born again. Yeah. The issue of salvation is one that is of utmost importance to every single human being living here on earth. It doesn't matter if you're black or white, if you're Asian, African, European, if you're from the Caribbean like us, it simply doesn't matter what background you're from. It doesn't matter what family background you have. The Bible tells us that there is no other need given among men under heaven that whereby we should be saved, and that is the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible also tells us that we are not saved or we're not redeemed by perishable things such as gold or silver, but we are redeemed by the precious blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You see, if salvation wasn't a big issue, if our sin wasn't a big issue before God, then Jesus wouldn't have to die such a horrible and brutal and agonizing death. You see, the death that Jesus died was the death that we should have died. When he suffered on that cross, and even before he went on the cross, he was made to suffer. The Roman guards, they beat him mercilessly. They stripped him naked. And I know that when we look at any of the movies like The Passion of the Christ or any other movie that depicts the crucifixion of Jesus, we always see the actor, when he's on the cross, he has a piece of cloth covering his genitals. But the truth of the matter is that when Jesus went on that cross, he was up there completely naked, completely humiliated for the world to see. There was no glory in it. There was no dignity in it. It was completely demeaning. It was completely humiliating. And he was stripped of every ounce of decency that he deserved as a human being, that he deserved as God, because he was God. And he is God, and he died as God on the cross for the sins of humanity. And I know that this evening that, you know, we all want different gifts. And I know that with the introduction of my message, I talked about who wants a house, who wants a car, and who wants land, and et cetera, et cetera. And these things are good, as I've said. You know, God wants to bless us. God wants to provide for his creation, and he wants to provide for his children. But the greatest gift and the most important gift that anyone can receive is the gift of salvation. The Bible tells us in Matthew chapter 6 that if ye seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, then all these things shall be added unto you. Right? So I'm encouraging you all this evening, everyone under the hearing of my voice, to seek God first and put God first in all your ways. The Bible tells us that we should not lean on our own understanding, but in all our ways, we should put God first, and He will guide our path, and He will make our ways straight. The Bible also tells us that the Word of God is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path, meaning that when we give our lives to Christ, He's the one that opens our understanding. He's the one that opens up he gives us knowledge to be victorious and to be a conqueror in this world. And this is the will of God for you, that you should confess Jesus as your Lord and Savior, that you should come into his kingdom. All of us, we all know the story of Nicodemus. The Pharisee that visited Jesus by night, because of course, you know, he was a Pharisee, and the Pharisees didn't like Jesus, so he didn't want to be seen with Jesus in the public's eye. And Nicodemus asked Jesus, "What must I do to enter into the kingdom of God?" And he said, "Ye must be born again." And Nicodemus was confused. How can a man go back into his mother's womb and be born again? But the spiritual birth that Jesus is talking about is an inner spiritual birth, a rebirth of your spiritual nature. You see, when we are born, we are all born sinners. We are all born with a propensity to sin and to do that which is against God and to do that which is wrong. But when we are born again, when we confess Jesus as our Lord and Savior, when we ask Him into our hearts and lives, the Holy Spirit comes into us. He comes into our spirit and transforms our spirit and makes us a child of God. And contrary to popular belief, not everyone is a child of God. Not everyone is a creation of God, but we only become children of God and sons of God when we receive the Spirit of God, and the Spirit of God lives in us. And the only way the Spirit of God can live in us is through the salvation experience, through asking Jesus to be the Lord and Savior of your life. So this evening, I will encourage you, even though you may want all the things of this world, and it's not a sin to desire to live comfortably, it's not a sin to have money, to have the good things in life, but in all your seeking, seek ye first the kingdom of God. Seek God first, and He will direct your paths, and He will make your way straight, and He will guide you in all the ways of your life, and He will place you on a plate. He'll put you on a rock to stand, and He will establish you in this life. But again, I want to reiterate, the most important thing for any human being is their relationship with God and the condition of their soul. Remember, God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. It's not God's will that any should perish. It's not God's will that any of our sins should take us to hell. Because the reality is that God doesn't send anyone to hell. Everyone is born on their way to hell. What God does, or what He's trying to do, is to rescue us from hell by encouraging us and by sending us messengers who will tell us about the gospel of Jesus Christ and who will point us to Jesus so that we can be saved before our time is up. And in this life, the most important thing that you can ever do is trust Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. So this evening, I just pray that you would truly indeed trust Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Young people who are here, I can say for a fact that after being a Christian for 20 years, I gave my life to Jesus when I was 12 years old. I'm now 33. And I can say for a fact that I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor a seed begging for bread. God has never disappointed me once. I may have failed Him, but He's never failed me. And He has guided me in my life's path, and He's given me victory in every area of my life. And even though it wasn't easy, and it's never easy, there are some times where you may feel like giving up. You may feel like not, serving God. But I want to tell you that when you push through and when you continue to trust God, He brings you through and He brings you deliverance and He helps you to overcome and be triumphant. So this evening, I just pray that as we remember the life of our dear brother, Winston Archibald Kingston, that you would truly consider the sacrifice that our Lord and Savior made, and that you would truly accept Him as your Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 So at this time, we're going to have our closing prayer. So everyone, bow your heads, close your eyes. And yes, you may stand. Stand as we have our closing prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the life of our dear brother, Winston Archibald Hinkson. We thank you for what you have accomplished through him in this life, and we thank you for his impact on others in this life. And we want to thank you, O God, for your Son, Jesus Christ, most of all, the one who was and is to come, the one who died for us, who sacrificed himself on the cross for our sins, and the one who is calling all of us to a deeper relationship and a deeper walk with him. And Father, you have said in your word, your Son, that this is eternal life, that we may know you, Father God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. So Father God, I just pray for your blessing to be upon every single person here at this funeral service. We pray for comfort for the family, that you would comfort them and give them solace, that your Holy Spirit would convict them, and that everyone here who doesn't know Jesus as their Lord and Savior would experience the conviction of the Holy Spirit, and that they'll be convicted of their sins, and that they would repent of their sins and come to you and confess Jesus as their Lord and Savior and serve him for the rest of their lives. So Father, we commend the rest of this service into your hands, and we pray that, and that as we go to the cemetery, that your Spirit will go with us, and that you would grant us peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, so at this time, we're going to have our closing song, The Goodness of God, as we remain standing. And that song is on page 4. And so we're going to sing along with the music.
I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Sing of
Your goodness is running after me.
Your goodness is running out of my surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, is running after me. All my life you have been faithful. Thank you.
and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. For as much as it pleased Almighty God of his mercy to take unto himself the soul of Winston Archibald Hinkson, we therefore commit his body to the earth, from whence it came, earth to earth, dust to dust, in hope of the resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
This hymn for me.
Be not dismayed.
Uh-huh. Yeah, hold on.
Be not
dismayed, whatever betide. God will take care of you. Beneath his wings above high, God will take care of you. God will take care of you. Through every day. God will take care of you.
Some glad morning when this life is o'er, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. When the shadows of this life have flown, I'll fly away. Like a bird from prison bars has flown, I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away. Die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
So now I'm going to give the benediction. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, also I want to thank all of you for coming and to pay a tribute to our dear brother Winston Archibald Hinkson, and I just pray that that you would have an enjoyable evening. Amen. Praise Amen. The Lord.
From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so faithful. of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire and in darkest night. You are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. Hey! 'Cause all my life you have been faithful.
Oh, yes, you have.
Every praise
is to
praise.
Every praise
is to our God.
To our God.
I don't care how you're feeling right now.